Aloha everyone, welcome back. Today we are going to be making some of these sweet little gnome ornaments. And I have made it extremely easy for you all because I have purchased things off of Amazon that come in kits. You can pick almost everything up at one time. This kit, all the links will be provided below in the description box. If you click on the three dots or the words that say show more, it will open it up and all that information will be in there. Now this kit itself had, we have ribbon, we have three different sizes of wooden balls. They are a little bit bigger than what I wanted for this project, so I will be using all the small ones. And I'll see how I like the big ones in the end. But they also have all the beards already trimmed. Now, I've worked with fur trim before, and it is not fun to cut. So having it already cut into the sizes that you need is perfect. So that's one thing I got. The other thing I got was a bunch of these little wooden, like little tree trunk type things here. And in this kit, it has some twine, regular twine, some candy cane twine, and stencils. So I'm not gonna use the stencils this time, but for another craft, they'll come in perfect. So these, again, I'll have in the description box below, I believe are 2.5 to 3 inch pieces of wood, okay? Let's see. With the hat, I made my own template. This is about 5.5 inches long. So I just made a triangle and I measured this about 2.5 inches. I put it a little bit bigger because I wanted to sew, but you don't need to sew in order to make this. You can instead just glue everything. It's not absolutely necessary. So I cut it 2.5 here and then I just opened it up and doubled it. And so that will be your template. So just draw a triangle that is 5.5 inches by 2.5 inches and then double it. These jingle bells all came in three different sizes and there are 200 pieces. I think it's like $5, if even that. We have cotton balls because it's what I have on hand and it's easier to use than the stuff that you use for stuffing. And then I bought another thing here with little resin type acrylic maybe pieces of Christmas. One of them has all glittered stuff, as you see. I've been using a lot of the glitter ones and these are the ones without the glitter, just as cute, so I'm going to start using those as well. Let's see, you need a glue gun and a scissors, of course, and you'll more than likely need a needle to go with the twine in order to make the hanging ornament. Okay, so the first thing that I do, I also use a pen so that I can stuff the hats, and I use about 2 to 3 of these. I'm gonna do the one that doesn't need, I mean that's already sewn, so I can get this done quicker. So I tore a cotton ball in half and with my pen I'm just gonna kind of stick her all the way up into the very top. And then I just kind of loosen up the cotton balls so that they're not so very stiff. But I'm only gonna stuff this about halfway to about 3/4 maybe. the way down. Because I do want to bring the hat down a little low, and that about fills it up. See? Okay, so these came pre-drilled, so you want to make sure that you put the pre-drilled part underneath here and simply hot glue the pieces down. These are going to be the fastest, simplest ornaments to make after you've, you know, cut everything up. And I'm going to grab a jingle bell. I'm not, since the hat is, this is a, called a palaka print. It's very popular here in Hawaii. The plantation workers used to use palaka prints back in the day. So I'm just gonna put a little bit of glue on top of the jingle bell and stick her right there. We're gonna put this cute little teddy bear and glue the back of that and put her on the hat. You don't have to use that, you know, to decorate the hat. I kind of felt like it was almost overwhelming at first, but then I let other people talk me into adding it in just because it is quite cute. So then I'm going to put a little bit of glue right on top of that for the nose, and I'm going to put her right there at the end of the fabric. I'm going to get one of these pre-cut beards. Should have cleared off my area before I start doing all this stuff. And then I'm going to run out of glue stick, it looks like, since I've been going at it and I said, hey, I better film this. So I set up quickly to do this. So it's not the best setup. You're going to stick this right up under the nose, covering the fabric, and then circling around the side. If it did not catch, you want to just kind of make sure you put a little bit more glue back there to make sure it stays down. For all intents and purposes, we are complete. Dunzo. Now, I would go back to the twine, and I would cut it. I don't have my sewing needle with me right now, but I would make her, because it's, you know, the beard is fairly long, I wouldn't make her very long in terms of having the ornament hold, hook or whatever's. And I just realized that we don't even need to sew it. We can just go ahead and glue it since we're gluing everything else. So I would glue it from behind. Oops, sorry. Glue it from behind. And there we go. We're complete. Oh, my neighbor's home. Welcome to the hood. Welcome to my neighborhood. And there you go. The cutest little gnome ornament done in just no time flat. I hope you enjoyed. And I should let you know that I am an Amazon affiliate. So if you do use the links, that I make a tiny portion, and I'm talking tiny portion of the sales from there. So there you go. cute little gnome ornaments for your tree. This one I used some Hawaiian fabric, so it says Aloha. This one, like I said, is a very popular fabric in Hawaii called Palaka. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up and let me know if you did enjoy. Thanks. We'll see you again soon.